I bet you've experienced stress at some point in your life, and perhaps it's even present for you right now. That's why we're here to help you better understand how stress affects you and how meditation can work as an effective cure. We will discover the biology of stress and learn how meditation can transform your brain, bringing deep relaxation, resilience, and well-being. Join us on this journey where we explore the remarkable power of meditation as it rewires your neural pathways, reducing stress and anxiety while fostering mindfulness and personal growth. Get ready to take charge and find inner peace amidst the chaos. I am Linda Granforce.
And I am Alessandro Carpentiero. We at Beyond Sapiens help you maximize your human potential by optimizing your mind, body, and work.
Let's start by exploring what stress is and how it affects you biologically. Simply put, stress is your body's response to pressure, causing physical, mental, or emotional tension. When faced with challenging situations, your brain orchestrates a complex interplay among various regions, including the amygdala, alarming for danger, and activating the hypothalamus, pituitary gland, and adrenal glands, known as the HPA axis. It all starts in your brain's hypothalamus, which releases corticotropin-releasing hormones in response to stress. These hormones signal your pituitary gland to release adrenal corticotropin hormone, which then travels through your bloodstream to reach the adrenal glands atop your kidneys. Subsequently, your adrenal glands releases stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline, preparing your body to confront or escape the stressor. While acute stress and the associated hormone releases can be beneficial in certain situations, chronic, prolonged stress can have detrimental effects on your health. This happens because prolonged activation of stress response strains your cardiovascular system, leading to cardiovascular problems, high blood pressure, and arterial hardening. Moreover, it weakens your immune system, making you more susceptible for infections and diseases. Additionally, chronic stress disrupts the delicate balance of neurotransmitters in the brain, affecting the communication between neurons and impairing crucial cognitive processes such as memory, attention, and decision-making abilities. This cognitive impairment, coupled with the constant release of stress hormones, increases the risk of developing anxiety disorders and depression. This can also lead to disrupted sleep and eating patterns, further impacting your overall mental well-being. Fortunately, meditation offers an effective solution to counteract these adverse effects of stress. In the upcoming chapters, we will explore the intriguing concept of neuroplasticity and how meditation can reshape your brain. We will delve into the transformative effects of meditation on the amygdala, reducing its reactivity and controlling your fear response. Additionally, we will explore how meditation positively influences your prefrontal cortex, the part of your brain responsible for cognitive control and emotional regulation.
As Linda explained, there's a lot going on in our brains when we're stressed, but there's a remarkable, accessible, and natural tool that can help: meditation. To comprehend why meditation can be such a powerful ally in stress management, we need to explore the concept of neuroplasticity. Neuroplasticity refers to the extraordinary ability of the brain to reorganize and reshape itself by forming new connections between neurons. It allows the brains to adapt, learn, and change based on our experiences and the information we acquire. Essentially, it's the brain's way of rewiring itself to create more efficient pathways. And the fascinating part is that neuroplasticity is a lifelong process that continues throughout our entire lives. So, what does meditation have to do with all this? Scientific research has revealed that regular meditation practice can enhance neuroplasticity, particularly in regions of the brain associated with stress regulation, such as the hippocampus and the prefrontal cortex. Let's focus on the hippocampus, a crucial area responsible for memory and emotional regulation. Through meditation, the hippocampus undergoes positive changes, becoming more resilient and better equipped to handle stressors. But what exactly happens in the brain during meditation to promote neuroplasticity? The brain enters a state of focused attention and relaxation. In this state, the growth of new neurons is promoted, along with the formation of new connections between them. These connections strengthen the neural pathways associated with stress regulation and relaxation. As you continue to practice meditation, these connections become stronger, leading to lasting changes in how your brain responds to stress. That's why, by cultivating a regular meditation practice, you not only improve your ability to manage stress, but also enhance your overall well-being. Remember, the brain is not fixed or rigid. Actually, quite the contrary. It has the incredible capacity to change and adapt. Through meditation and the wonders of neuroplasticity, you have the power to literally transform your brain and your relationship with stress.
Another way how meditation rewires your brain is that it affects your amygdala, the start station of your stress response, an important brain structure involved in emotional processing. By training your mind to focus and redirect thoughts, meditation offers a solution to regulate the activity of the amygdala and counteract the effects of chronic stress. Meditation teaches you to observe and understand your thoughts and emotions without judgment. This practice creates mental clarity and emotional stability, allowing your brain to perceive events and emotions as less threatening and stressful. As a result, the activation of your stress response decreases significantly. Personally, I have experienced this power of meditation in remaining calm during situations that used to cause anxiety. I have gained better control over my thoughts, and I'm less reactive and sensitive to stress and pressure. Also, whenever I do feel stress, it is less intense. I can overcome it much faster. Scientific studies also support this. It is shown that individuals with extensive meditation experience have smaller amygdala volumes compared to non-meditators. This suggests that meditation induces structural changes in the brain regions associated with emotional processing. Functional magnetic resonance imaging fMRI studies have further demonstrated that meditation can modulate the amygdala's reactivity. For instance, mindfulness-based stress reduction programs have been found to decrease amygdala activation in response to emotional stimuli. In essence, meditation promotes a balanced and adaptive emotional state by regulating the amygdala's response to emotions. The implications of these changes are significant. Meditation reduces anxiety and emotional reactivity and fosters emotional resilience, enabling emotional balance even in challenging situations.
Besides the amygdala, meditation has a fascinating impact also on the prefrontal cortex, the control center of your brain located right behind your forehead. The prefrontal cortex plays a vital role in executive functions such as decision-making, emotional regulation, and impulse control. However, chronic stress can impair its functioning, making it challenging to effectively manage stress. Fortunately, meditation offers invaluable support. Scientific research has revealed that regular meditation strengthens connections between the prefrontal cortex and other brain regions, resulting in enhanced emotional regulation and clear-headed decision-making, even in the face of stress. But how exactly does meditation influence the prefrontal cortex? Pioneering studies by Harvard neuroscientist Dr. Sarah Lazar and her colleagues have shed light on the changes occurring in the brain of regular meditators. They discovered that they have relatively thicker prefrontal cortexes compared to those who do not meditate regularly. And the fascinating thing is that the thickness of the prefrontal cortex directly correlates with the amount of meditative practice. Furthermore, they discovered that meditation increases the density of gray matter in specific areas responsible for planning, decision-making, problem-solving, and emotional regulation within the prefrontal cortex. In addition to these benefits, meditation also helps prevent age-related shrinkage of the prefrontal cortex. While it is a well-established fact that the prefrontal cortex naturally shrinks as we age, research has shown that experienced meditators who were 50 years old at the time of the study had similar levels of gray matter within the prefrontal cortex as their 25-year-old counterparts. On top of that, meditation has also been found to increase activity in the left prefrontal cortex, which is associated with feelings of happiness and well-being. Studies led by Dr. Richard Davidson at the University of Wisconsin-Madison demonstrate that regular meditation practice enhances activity in this region, ultimately fostering greater happiness and overall well-being.
We hope this video has helped you make new connections in your brain and learn something valuable. By practicing meditation, you can reduce stress, heal chronic stress, and become less reactive to stressful situations. This in turn gives you better control over your thoughts and emotions, improves your focus, and brings balance to your life, allowing you to reach your full potential. If you're interested in learning more about meditation and the fascinating world of the brain, or if you'd like to start your Beyond Sapiens journey, you can schedule a free call with Alessandra and me using the link in the description. You can also visit our website beyondsapiens.co to find out more about us. Remember, your brain is capable of incredible things. Embrace the opportunity to explore and grow and unlock your potential free from stress.
And if you want to gain innovative ideas and solutions to optimize your mind, body, and work, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our weekly science-based videos. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next week.